Los Angeles, the city of angels. More like the city of traffic.
My name is Jeff Sparks, and I'm a filmmaker.
I've been living in and around Los Angeles, Hollywood really, for over 20 years. I'm from Oregon, and I really need the balance of nature versus city and slow life versus fast life. I found it at times up at Lake Hollywood, but I really found it back in 86, in Idyllwild.
Where is Idyllwild, you ask? Well, 120 miles south of Los Angeles, in between Palm Springs and the Inland Empire, on top of the San Jacinto Mountains, is Idyllwild. Okay, it's 2 hours from Hollywood. There is some history of Hollywood in Idyllwild. Elvis Presley shot Kid Galahad back in 1961. Albert Brooks filmed some of Modern Romance back in 1981. And you can't forget Bonanza, who shot in the Gardner Valley on the edge of the Idyllwild wilderness. Taquitos Rock, for a long time, was Brad Pitt's favorite place to climb. Bottom line, Idyllwild is where you go to find some balance from down below. I love Idyllwild.
I've always been on the hunt for a cool scene. I found one back in 97, the Idyllwild Film Institute, that became the Idyllwild International Film Festival. But this last summer, I discovered the Crazy Squirrel. I found a shop at the top of the town, the Funky Bazaar, and would meet its proprietor, a man who held some whimsy, a sense of humor, and was just cool.
Welcome to the most unusual shop in town. Now, I live here, so make yourself at home.
All right.
And I am a big supporter of local arts and crafts. Where are you from?
Los Angeles.
Me too. I was in Los Angeles for 25 years. Anyway, then I found this place. Okay. So, I'm a, like I said, big supporter of local arts and crafts, and I'm not a snob. So if your craft is knitting like Karen, sculpting like Dan, undead dolls, pussy soap, and Idyllwild, yes, it's very funny. And Idyllwild souvenir candles. If you're in my shop, you must be exclusive to me as a local artist.
Okay.
Three floors, each one is different, right? Right here is a little entrance to a staircase that goes downstairs. Down there is what I call the where the heck did you get all this cool stuff room number one. I do not buy anything from a catalog. But if I come across a modern item, it has to pass my cool test before I put it in here. Okay. And as you can tell, I'm really
you're very cool.
Okay, that's number two. Left-hand side upstairs, the smallest art gallery and performance area in Idyllwild. I reserve that for the locals who do not do birds, squirrels, landscapes, hunched Indians, and horseback, bears, mountains, or flowers. This is for the more alternative and or left-hand or right-of-center artists that cannot find a home here, so I made one for them. And then finally, over here, since I'm equal opportunity, I created what I lovingly call the girls' room and the kids' room. Mm. See? Mm-hmm. Something for everybody.
How about it? All right. So go down low and come on up, huh?
I didn't expect to find this. I didn't expect to be involved. What I discovered was something that's kind of missing in our hustle and bustle fast lives of electronics, the internet, and cell phones. Community. And great music. In the forest, in the mountains. Wow. Little did I know, but I had been bitten by the Crazy Squirrel. I would spend the whole summer there. I was in, from the moment I walked into the Funky Bazaar. What is the Crazy Squirrel? Idyllwild, great music, and amazing people, all wrapped up in a concert series. I discovered one hell of a happening.
Welcome to the second annual, I'm proud to say that, Crazy Squirrel Summer Concert Series. Okay, this is known as word of mouth. It is my private club, and you are all welcome to be here 7 days a week, anytime you want. You can come here and hang out, work on your computer, bring some food, just have a quiet place to come. But I also want this to be a venue for local and off-field artists to entertain us.
Yeah.
Now,
Word of mouth is basically for locals to have an alternative and come and enjoy music that they may not have heard before or bands that they have not seen before. But tonight, we decided to have the best classic rock band, who is local, to perform in a party atmosphere. So I'll sing along. The eclectic stuff will come later. Tonight, let's just have some fun.
You guys plan to perform well.
Season, the Crazy Squirrel series, and we were honored. We always played at a coffee house, Higher Grounds Coffee House here in Idyllwild, and God, it just sounded like such a great idea. We loved the venue. It was outdoors. We could play as loud as we wanted. Lots of times we felt like we had to get a little quieter at the coffee house, and so Peter promised us that we could be as loud as we wanted.
Opened the Funky Bazaar, which was the shop, and I wanted it to be, you know, a little more unusual than most of the shops in town. Not as a competition, but more as a compliment, you know, so that when tourists come up here, not only do they get to go to the tourist shops, but they can also get to go up here to the top of the town where there's Bubba's Books, there's the Idle Beast Museum Research Center, and me in the middle, the Funky Bazaar. So I thought, wow, a little eclectic, you know, mall type of area where there's three shops that are kind of different than the ones you have in town. And then my landlord owns this property. He's the one that owns Idle Beast Museum. I cleaned this area up because I had an idea. I had an idea of maybe this area could be used as a concert venue or as a performance venue. And so it took me a little over a year to clean out all the shrubbery and all the junk that was back here. And then I started collecting chairs that people were going to throw out and tables that people were throwing out and spray painted them so that they didn't look bad, and then started to realize, like, wow, this is looking pretty funky. You know, in the middle of the woods, you've got purple, green, yellow chairs, and this stage was already here. So I thought, okay, why don't we have performances here? So for about a year, I kind of had it as a private club where you could come and just hang out. Few people used it, but it was when I started having events, when I started having people perform here is when people really started to come and started to enjoy this little bohemian in the forest area. And our first concert was called A Concert to Save a Life. And there was a gentleman up here who desperately needed a medical machine and couldn't get it. It was too expensive, and the insurance companies or whatever, you know, were dicking around whether or not they were going to buy it for him. And, but the guy could die any day. So Lily McCabe and Wayne Cameron came to me. They're Swift Pony. They're the ones that are, I'm putting on this, these shows with. Came to me and said, hey, why don't we do a benefit for this guy? And they have a lot of musical connections. So we put together one big show, 5-6 different musicians, put the word out that, you know, we're doing this to buy this medical machine for this local guy. In that one day, we raised over $5,000 and were able to get him the machine and additional money to, you know. So then I thought, okay, if this worked that well, why not try to, you know, not always have a benefit for somebody, but just try and utilize this space for music and performances. And Idyllwild is huge with music. I mean, it's a big musical town.
Little cutie right here in the stroller. He was like, yeah, he got his neck into it. It was awesome.
One of the things about Idyllwild is that it's also a very big jazz town. And we have the jazz festival every year. It's very successful. We have Cafe Aroma, who has a lot of jazz playing, you know, and there's other venues that, you know, showcase local musicians. And it's a very jazz oriented community. And so I thought, well, if I'm going to do another venue in this town, I wanted to give an alternative, make a compliment to the town. And a lot of the locals who live here, you know, they go to these restaurants and they've seen the players and, you know, they're looking for something different. So I wanted to give them an opportunity to have a choice as to whether, you know, they want to hear jazz tonight or, you know, another band that plays up here or something different that's never been here. So Swift Pony, Lily and Wayne, I talked to them about it and we decided, okay, well, let's do a concert series and we'll get the majority of the musicians from off hill, ones that have never played up here or have played up here so infrequently that it would feel like it's new. So again, with the concept of being a compliment or an alternative choice, we created the Crazy Squirrel Concerts. And it's you know, I lovingly say anything from punk rock to polka.
Started early and went to sundown, and your back and your hands for the living you earned.
Waiting for an answer.
There's no deep pockets here. There's no money here. This is all done because we want to do it. There's no backup. Unless these people support it, then there's nothing. So we'll see tonight. We'll see after we count the till.
Doing something that Idyllwild is worthy of, and will continue to be worthy of in the future.
Because there's no other place like the Funky Bazaar.
Well, there's no other place like Idyllwild, and as far as I know, the Funky Bazaar really represents what the fundamental purpose of both Idyllwild and the nation as a whole should be independent and
sure.
That's a good thing, even if it does come from a Canadian. But you know.
Nice.
You know,
no, it's pretty unique. There's a couple, there were a couple like kind of spring up weird pop-up hippie scene things going on for a little while at a few places, but they just like pop up and go away. This one was very consistently coming back every week. You know, I really enjoyed that about it. It's just, God, it's the best venue up here, period. Thank you.
To say that no matter what town we're talking about, it's defined by the people that live here. And I have to say that Idyllwild and the Crazy Squirrel Concert Series is an amazing place to play. I had so much fun tonight, and it's all because of the people that showed up and supported the music that I was playing tonight. So thank you all so much for that. It means a lot to me.
I'm a latchkey kid.
We have so many friends off the hill, amazing musician friends and people we know, and we wanted to provide a place for them where they could come and play in a beautiful setting for a listening audience, which is just rarer and rarer to find all the time, and we know that so well as musicians that, you know, yeah, being able to play for an attentive audience is like... so yeah. Hard and
it's hard to find.
It's not hard, it's hard to find, yeah. And so yeah, we just wanted to be able to bring our friends up and give them that experience and also hopefully pay them somewhat generously,
right?
So the word
started getting out pretty rapidly that how beautiful this place is, and it is so different than going to a bar and playing for a bunch of people who are just yapping, you know. And you've got this kind of have this din in a bar like that that you have to come up over, and it's, you know, maybe 100 human voices, and so it's your human voice and your guitar or your violin that's kind of in that same range, and you're trying to express, you know, your music up over this noise floor already. And here you can hear a pin drop when these performances start, and so it's a real treat.
Well, I'm a big fan of the Crazy Squirrel Concert Series. I think it's the brainchild, the love child of Wayne Cameron and Lily McCabe. I think they want to bring great music up here to Idyllwild and also provide a venue for wonderful musicians. It's a sad fact that these days there's less great places to play, and live music isn't valued like it has been in the past. So here's an opportunity for folks in Idyllwild to hear great musicians, and usually Southern California musicians, but people that aren't Idyllwilders. And so they make a point of bringing people up that aren't people from Idyllwild specifically, but they come from nearby areas, and you get to hear music you wouldn't hear ordinarily. And it's certainly not about the money, because I think this concert series, I'd be surprised if it broke even. But it's a labor of love. It's a chance to bring art to a wonderful art town. And I think everybody's really delighted that those guys are willing to sacrifice a considerable amount of time and I think some money in order to bring great musicians up here to Idyllwild. So it should be added that Lily and Wayne are fine musicians themselves, and I've had a great deal of pleasure playing with a couple of bands with Lily that I put together, and what she adds to those groups is immeasurable. You know, I have a jazz grass group that's a cross between bluegrass and jazz, and also I put together a trio, and we finally added Wayne and made it a quartet. That was just basically a feature of her amazing voice and her amazing violin playing. She's just a spectacularly talented lady, and so we're all hoping her well with her new venture in the Bay Area, following her muse into the world of counseling. But we all want her to continue playing music. She's absolutely spectacular, so I'm sure it's because they're such good musicians that they have a good ear for good music, and a lot of the people they brought up are just amazing. It's a great rock band, and the Cougars, and Thomas Lieb, I wasn't able to see him, but I was able to take part in the show with Dave Blackburn, Robin Adler, and John Quint, and Matt, and it was just amazing. So the people turned out for it, and I hope they do it again next year. And if you haven't had a chance to see one of them, you should come, because it's great music in a beautiful natural setting. Peter gets a lot of credit for having this space right near the Funky Bazaar, and so I think it's an incredible addition to the arts town of Idyllwild. For a small town, we actually have quite a few musicians and artists up here.
Thank you. Well, my name is Tara Honda. I'm from the Temecula area, and I'm an indie pop rock artist. I've been doing this. I've been singing for a long time. This whole thing has been quite a new journey. So, hope you guys enjoy this song. It's called "Watching Out." I'll be recording an EP soon, so hopefully it'll be available on that good stuff, Spotify and iTunes. So, here we go. Hope you guys have a good evening. Makes sense, and all this road will go untouched. It makes sense, and with my mind so untamed, it's gone wild. Brace the storm and let go, it's so natural. Of me. let loose and be made. Why have I been so afraid to let all let loose and be made? Because you I'm here at the Crazy Squirrel Concert Series, and oh my gosh, I love playing here. I hope I can play here again. Everyone is just so friendly and inviting, and oh my gosh, the music, all of the artists that were playing before were amazing, and it has such a fun vibe, and I don't know, just a good sense of just community and everyone supporting each other and just having a great time and, you know, having some wine. So thank you so much for having me here. I truly appreciated it. I love playing here. And I can't wait to come here back again if you guys would have me.
Idyllwild is this really wonderful town. It's beautiful, it's in the middle of nothing but cities, and it's just this wonderful mountain paradise. And it's very hard to find, but once you're here, it's very hard to leave. And it's quite beautiful, and it's packed full of some of the most brilliant talent I've seen in Southern California since I've been here. And it's kind of funny because there's not a lot of huge venues in this town. There's the Idyllwild Arts Academy, which is a beautiful program, and then there's a lot of little restaurants. And so when you have a big gathering with semi-loud music, there's not really anywhere in town you can play at, unfortunately. So it's really neat to see word of mouth happening now, because now we have a venue in this town that just has endless amounts of talent and art and music, and there's a place for it to go where it can be as loud as it needs to, as many people can enjoy it as they want to, and it exists right here in this beautiful mountain paradise. And I'm really excited to see how much further it goes next summer.
Too much that you can't do when you're traveling pale. the hottest party in town. It's the hottest private ticket. And to get your private ticket, all you gotta do is come here and say I'm here. And I give you the pass to get in. It is the only speakeasy in Idyllwild. It is the only place where you can have fun and pay what you can to support it. Okay? So, come on down to Word of Mouth. Come on down to the Funky Bazaar. And come on down to the Crazy Squirrel Summer Concert Series. Because it's the coolest thing.
Let's do that. That's awesome, huh?
Did a Crazy Squirrel Concert Series.
Funky Bazaar, Jared.
Yeah, it's the Funky Bazaar.
We did that.
And we just played an amazing show in probably one of the best settings we've probably ever played a show in, yeah.
Most beautiful.
Hands down.
Yeah. Most beautiful stage I've ever played
I wish we played here while we were on tour.
Yeah. But we just played it. It was phenomenal. There was a great crowd. Amazing energy.
Great people.
Yeah. It's been a long time since you play a lot of shows and you honestly don't. You expect to play to a room of people that you're kind of the background noise, and it is the exact opposite here. And the environment was so chill, and Wayne and Lily were beyond
amazing.
Yeah.
Beyond amazing.
Not only that, like Peter said, how he gave us an idea of what it would sound like before we started playing, and it sounded great. Mm-hmm. Like, not just from down here, but from listening to baseball after Help and Owen played.
Oh. Well, I guess I can't say, yeah, I'm in baseball, but when you guys sounded good too, I guess. No, but yeah, it was phenomenal.
Amazing.
I think we're already coming back in a month, right?
Oh, yeah, I can't wait till I come back here.
Yeah, September 6th,
maybe? Something like
September
that.
6th.
Yes, September 6th. So, yeah, support it with everything you can, and this is the kind of stuff that's going to make music better in the long run and make people come together, and art and community and all that stuff that just go hand in hand are going to really develop in places like this and not in bars and clubs that are trying to make a quick dime. So, yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers to that.
Cheers to that.
it was different than anything I've ever experienced up here. The eclectic noise that came from this place was pretty phenomenal. I've never seen such a bunch of incredibly talented musicians who were willing to come up here and perform in this magnificent spot for love. And the people that came, it was all about just community. I mean, it was so cool. It was, and the acoustics here, I can't even tell you. The acoustics are, picture the Hollywood Bowl without the bowl, with pines and cedars, and it's a wall of sound. You had to have been here to really appreciate it, but this documentary is going to give you ideas on what this concert was like, this concert series. But every single act that came up here was completely different from the one before it. The local acts were phenomenal. The off-the-hill acts were phenomenal. And every single one of the musicians said they would love to come back. It was just, it was an absolutely amazing, what was it, 6 weeks or 8 weeks?
Eight weeks. 13, actually.
15?
13.
13.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Wow, it went that fast. It went, I can't believe it was of music. It just, it was perfect.
I guess 38 started at one point last week, what was left over. You know, and like, and then there's guys like, you know, like Weezer writing songs about Nirvana tunes, inspiring.
Oh, come on, we're not going to go to the
band. Let's just say 50 bands. Bucks.
Okay, so what you're saying, for us to be even tonight, based on tonight and before, $50 would make us even.
You know what I'm saying?
For tonight.
Like you go,
and going forward, in other words, there's nothing left over.
A poet.
No, there is. It's like, what's, I told you, what is still owed to me total for expenses from weeks previous and today is
$150. Yeah, they're well, gross.
But I'm not worrying about getting all of that back right now. So if you're okay,
it's cool.
With
yeah, I'll look at it.
Here,
definitely. Yeah, the Ivan is Artist series. I've had a couple of those. I had an Ivan is Artist.
What I get back towards expenses, and I'll knock it off the expenses.
So you're saying what's accumulated for expenses is about $155. So we've got basically $100.
Yeah, the 70s and 80s, Ivan has stuff back from like 78 to 84, 85 was so far above.
So
the US for that period.
If I give you just 50,
you know, I mean, heck, at that time, Fender had no. Let's see, early 80s, Fender had no US production at all. They were totally screwed up. Everything
that's
being made in Japan.
Right. And whatever I've spent, whatever I've done.
No, CBS,
so
CBS
nobody makes money.
No, nobody's making money. Yeah.
Okay.
That's the bottom line. So
so you take the 50. I'll take the 40.
Yeah, but no, they went through this horrible reorganization, and then everybody was, all the good guys just quit, and the production and the quality went so
50. Okay.
Right.
Oh, is that one of yours?
Drawing a Japanese plane. It's like he had some 80s era Japanese squatters.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
Sure. Okay.
Right. Okay. Yeah. So.
So it's just $100.
Let's get her
more expenses
and get you some food
over the next 6 weeks.
We're just gonna have to, modify our.
Well, I want to get Mike down to grab a bite to eat at the moment.
He's starving.
Okay. Oh, fine. Go to Aroma.
All right.
You know what? We can just walk there if you want.
All right. Okay, Peter.
Okay, so we're
good.
Good?
We're good.
All right.
We're all good? Yep.
Okay, we're good.
Okie dokie.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
My pleasure.
We'll see you soon. We have another good night.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
we don't have money. I mean, so it wasn't like, hey, we're gonna pay you to come here. This is a grand experiment, so to speak. I've already used that phrase, but the experiment was, look, we want to start a concert series. We do not have a bankroll, and we want to start it on a donation-based basis. So we came up with the idea of enticing other musicians who have the same kind of a dream, and also hopefully creating a venue that they could come back repeatedly. So basically we're saying, we will give you X amount of dollars out of the donation box as a guarantee. After that, whatever's left over, we'll do a third, a third, and a third. You know, a third for the house, a third for Swift Pony, and another third in addition to the basic promise on top of that, to help us create this concert series, you know. And the bands and the people and the musicians that Wayne and Lily contacted, you know, my guess is that most of them said, yeah, of course, why not? Let's create something. And so that's basically how it was conceived. You know, when you've got no money, you know, you can't say, hey, I'm going to guarantee you this, but you know what, if we create a concert series and it takes, then hopefully it'll grow and everybody will get more money and the venue will get bigger. So that's the experiment. Now we're in our second year and we have a full 12-week season to the end of August, whereas last year when we started it, Idyllwild suffered, international news. It was a fire. And so we were only able to have 3 concerts last year. So this is the first full year. And it's been growing steadily, and I think Crazy Squirrel, you know, has gotten to be very well known around town, and there's a lot of people, you know, that'll stop me at the coffee shop and say that they're planning their Fridays around these concerts. So that makes me feel really good. So we're not there yet. You know, we're not, there's no profit, you know, not right now. I mean, right now, I'm just really happy, we're all happy that all the musicians so far have gotten more than they were promised. The wine and cheese and the food that we supply has been paid for, and we walk away with a few dollars for the effort, but not enough to call it a profit, you know. But that's okay. I mean, there's a lot of concerts. You know, Wayne talked to me about some of the concerts he was looking at and how they started, and they were in the red for years before they start getting known and bigger. So are we in the red? Yeah, kind of, sort of. You know, we're not writing down everything like to the penny. But if the take at the end of the night covers the musicians, covers the food, and we walk away with $50 or something, oh, we're happy. So hopefully Crazy Squirrel will have a third year and a fourth year, and who knows, maybe one day we'll have to have like a bouncer at the door and sell tickets. Right now it's, you know, you come in, you get invited. Shake me up inside my soul.
Sometimes when I lose my faith in what the world sells, sometimes I'm a dreamer. Well, you know that by now.
Shoestring. We're all going out of our pockets to make this happen, and it's all just personally going to people and telling them about it and kind of and handing out flyers and putting up posters and doing Facebook and doing whatever we can. You know, particularly in the first several weeks, it was so much time and energy spent. I was getting we were both getting pretty stressed out about the least. But it's you know, and two, just kind of realizing that when you're doing, I mean, when we did the benefit concert, it was a one-time event that we were just pumping, and we were asking people, you know, all of our friends, we were casting the net far and wide, and people just responded so well, and it was just incredible and almost effortless in that sense that all the energy we were putting out, we were getting back tenfold.
That's right.
And in this instance, it hasn't been that way. And we were kind of anticipating the same similar enthusiasm level. But you know, the thing is, this is Idyllwild. There's so many things going on. There's so much music. There's so many events. There's so many things to do, and people have their own lives and their own schedules. And you know, we were, you know, it's just, it's difficult to get people to do something every week.
Well, and to keep it fresh in their minds that it's going on.
The old Warner place, sun shining square on his face, leaving work at 3:30 and he heads to the bakery uptown. Always wearing that old baggy shirt, fingernails caked in dirt. Hooded smile when he could see the little cap at the bakery uptown. You better walk the walk if you talk the talk. Yeah, one foot in front of the other. But she said with a smile, we'll rest in a while, but heaven is right now, brother. She always wore that little blue cap because it kept her hair held back. And he was hoping that he might see the day she gonna let her hair down. Now her life, it's elbows and grease, never mind a moment's peace. Looking ahead to when she might see the time she gonna let her hair down. You better walk the walk and talk the talk. Yeah, one foot in front of the other. But don't wait for the end, you're gonna miss it, friend. I said, heaven's right now, brother. Now some say heaven, but man, it's so far away. You wanna get there, you better get down on your knees and do everything they say.
I love this chair. It's shaped like me, it's soft and squishy and tall. And I sink into the cushions and I am small again. The light from the window shines upon my face, and I'm warm and sleepy in its light. The house is still. Not a sound except the ticking of a clock somewhere. A wind chime on the breeze calls to a flock of sheep. In the bay, a lobster boat is turning circles, pulling tonight's dinner from the sea. In the kitchen, I hear her kneading dough in her strong fingers. Flour dusts her cheeks and a tear lingers there. She is thinking of her mother who died some time ago. Bacon causes memories to rise. Silent pause, a stranger creeps in, purring loudly as he leaps into my lap. He curls up on my chest and blows my face with kitten breath, and I fall asleep. I fall asleep and dream about love.
Stage here at Crazy Squirrel, underneath the trees, and bats flying through, and all the people out on the rocks. It's just a lovely, beautiful evening and a great place to play.
It's a great house. The people come and they want to hear music, and that's very rare. You know, we're surrounded by music and sound and iPods and all that's always going on, but people very rarely want to hear music. And so when you come here and play at a place like this, it sticks with you for a long time, and you look forward to coming back and meeting these friendly people. And it's just about giving. Everybody's giving their time. Everybody's making donations, and it's getting better. I came here last year by myself, and this year we had this amazing performance by the great Jen Hodge, and better things are coming. I hope they have us both back sometime.
Yeah, it was good fun.
When my girlfriend and I moved up here just before the concert started, we really didn't know anyone in town yet, and the concerts were an absolutely unique and outstanding way to get to know so many of the local artists, and the sense of community that came with it, you know, meeting people in town the next day after a concert, going, "Hey, saw you last night," talking about it. Here I am as a result of it. The quality of the musicians was first rate. The quality of the people, the way everyone contributed to make it happen and support Peter and help his dream come to fruition, even though he did most of the work and this was a struggle. Don't let me diminish that. But it was so cool just being able to be a small part of the concert series.
There's a lot of people in Idyllwild, you know, or any place, you know, that can't really afford to go out, don't have a chance to go out. You know, I can't go out to a fancy restaurant and, you know, drop $100 or $200 and listen to music or whatever. So, you know, Crazy Squirrel was designed as a place where everybody could come and enjoy themselves, you know, because I think everybody deserves
an opportunity to go out. And that's why we have a suggested donation, but we imply that it's okay if you can't afford that. You know, put in as much as you can to help us, you know, keep this going. And one of my greatest joys is when I see, not that we get a lot of kids, but we do get some children here, you know, and, you know, parents bring their kids. And when I see them dancing on the rocks, you know, these six-year-olds, these eight-year-olds, and they're having a great time. And I know that they don't go out like this a lot. So to see that really, really warms my heart. And to see a family, you know, a couple or family, whatever, you know, be able to come here and just really get a chance to get out and enjoy themselves is really it's a pleasure for me. And so there is a very community and family oriented vibe down here, and that's the way I want to keep it.
I drank 16 doubles for the price of one, trying to get the courage to talk to you. When I asked her for a dance, not a second glance, my night had just begun. Well, I dreamed to the Father of the Holy Ghost, kneeling at the altar of my nightly post. I'll raise a glass, not the first nor last, come join me in this toast. As the old black rum has got a hold on me, like a dog wrapped around my leg. And the old black rum has got a hold on me, and I live for another day.
Sorry.
And I live for another day. George Street just went walking on by with some guy who doesn't care that she stood in line since 9:30 and spent 3 hours on her hair.
On her hair.
While her friends are looking at me with an evil grin, I think a bloody racket might soon begin. I must have said something to the George Street queen. The boys are joining in, 'cause the old black rum has got a hold on me, like a dog wrapped around my legs. The old black rum has got a hold on me, can I live for another day? Out in the rain, every day is different, but the nights are all the same. You never see the sun on the old black rum. Boys, I'm gonna do it again, 'cause the old black rum has got a hold on me, like a dog wrapped around my leg. The old black rum has got a hold on me, can I live for another day? Live for another day.
With any endeavor, there's always, you know, little hurdles to cross, little speed bumps, things you didn't, you know, you weren't aware of. And basically, as long as, you know, as long as those, when those bumps arise, or when those hurdles come up, you know, you just got to work together and say, okay, well, how do we resolve this for next issue, you know, next time and whatever. I mean, nothing is ever completely smooth. But that's the learning curve, you know, and as long as everybody's willing to say, okay, that worked or that didn't work, and, you know, talk about it and then improve it or find a solution. And so I wouldn't say it's been a rough road. I'd just say it's a surprising road. It's like, oh, we didn't think of that, or we didn't think of that. And then, you know, you sit down and you say, okay, how do we fix it, or how do we improve it? And I think that's just the birthing of anything. You know, that's how things get done. You know, is you can't think of everything. So when something comes up, you just tack it head on and get on with the show.
It's been a learning experience, big time. There's been some big trials and times of severe aggravation and, you know, just feeling like we're beating our heads against the wall. But you know what? Even this is what I kind of joke with Lily about this at the end of every show. Even if, you know, when everything is paid, if we're in the hole at the end of the show, I just go, well, okay, we paid for a couple, you know, what a couple would pay to go see Sting at the Forum. We just paid that tonight to see a really awesome band, front row seats, you know, and we didn't have to travel off the hill to do it. So yeah. It's kind of like, you know, in essence, we've, you know, probably the last 12 weeks, we've paid a decent amount of money to see some really great bands right here in our hometown, right. You know. So yeah, it's not all that bad. Right. It's not all that bad, you know. But there's been some screaming and crying and gnashing of teeth, and, you know, but. Two, you can't take things personally. If you put all this effort out there and this energy out there and it doesn't get the response that you think it should have, that's life. Life.
Yeah.
And we got to see some great music, got to hear some beautiful music. Mm-hmm. And we got to hand pick it, too,
right.
Which is pretty cool.
Right.
So
Crazy Squirrel is now becoming a brand.
Right.
What I would like to see is for us to figure out a way that if there is another year, and a year after that, that we build it to a point where everybody gets what they're supposed to get. But we can't expect that. Yes, we can't expect that the first fucking year.
Okay, well, we've been over all this territory many, many, many times, and we all understand that this is a building process. So, can I interject and we can make a decision about tonight?
What?
Can I offer a compromise? I take $50 back for expenses, and $75 each goes to Chuck and Jen.
We'll be right back.
amazing. It's a unique, one of a kind, spiritual experience, and I think that my woman and I are looking forward to hopefully coming back next year and getting married here. It's so special and spiritual. That's our goal.
Wow.
And hopefully we can get Peter to get his minister distinction and possibly marry us in the garden with the music. That was what we thought about when we saw the concert tonight. So it was pretty special.
Probably one of the best venues I've ever played in. Really, really enjoyed it, just being down in that natural amphitheater, audience just kind of surrounding us, mixed in with the shrubs and trees and rocks. It's really something else. And the event itself, the constant recycling of every Friday night, really cool. Peter and Wayne and Lily put together this event, and they just kept doing it week after week, and it was always really welcoming, and they had some good food there, and just every week there'd be another really great act that always made it, special to come out every week and know that you were going to get something good. Well, it definitely had a familial feel. Because, Peter has a lot of friends, and Wayne and Lily, and so you'd get just the friend thing happening, but then you started getting this little influx of just regular Friday nighters that live in Idyllwild coming out because it was such a great venue to hang. Whether it was down in the little grotto or on the hammock or just mingling with other people. So there was a social aspect to it, definitely. People, hanging out with their friends as well as coming for the music. So, yeah, I really liked that about it. And I could always count on coming in and seeing a lot of familiar faces. It's just amazing how really warm the audience was to the bands and the bands were to the audience, and this cycle of energy that would go on in this venue was just so magical. You know, and I got to play there twice this summer and really enjoyed it. So, I highly recommend going to shows there, and if you're a musician, I recommend playing there. It's really phenomenal. I'm looking forward to next year. I think we're going to do some really cool stuff with the stage and expanding the area so that we can have more people comfortably sitting and enjoying the music.
Crazy Squirrel got branded this year. We were fortunate that someone helped us get t-shirts. We were fortunate that we had incredible musicians and that the word did spread. And so hopefully next year when we do the third annual Crazy Squirrel concert, it'll be standing room only every time. You know, I mean, we did have great attendance this year, but it was still something that you're building. So I'm very proud of this year, and I'm proud of, you know, Wayne and Lily, you know, setting up the season. I'm proud of the locals that came in and supported it on a continuing basis. I'm proud of all the other attendees that either found out about it in a short term or knew about it and came back again because they liked the first one or the first one that they saw. So yeah, no, as far as I'm concerned, this season was extremely successful and extremely important. The good news is that I don't think we lost here. I think we at least broke even. And if you're gonna do a concert series and create a concert series and you can break even at this beginning stage, I think you've done something. So yeah, I'm proud of it. I'm proud of what word of mouth is gonna be on it. Get it? Word of mouth.
It's a real stretch for us this summer. Real stretch. Yeah. And something that probably a slightly more sane couple would not have even committed to.
With our schedules.
With our schedules and our financial limitations. I mean, particularly, I mean, if we did start this last year and we only ended up having three shows, so it wasn't that big of a deal. And I was not in school yet, but now I'm back in school getting my master's in the Bay Area, so I'm actually living two separate lives, and that's put a huge financial strain on us, which we were already kind of tight. And, you know, so we bit off a bit more than we could chew with this. That's kind of our style.
Right.
the biggest thing for me anyway has been the fact that every single band that we have brought up here, every act, even though we haven't been able to pay them nearly what we would have, what we wanted to, is that they loved the experience.
Yeah.
They loved it. And every single one of them said they wanted to come back.
Right.
And some of them want to come back with more. They want to bring more people and they want to do a bigger show. And,
right. So we'll need a bigger stage.
Right. Yeah. So yeah. That really does, I mean, that's the true kind of meter of, okay, right, is this really working or not? Because that really has to boil down to the musician's experience and satisfaction.
Right.
And, you know, despite whatever we might be feeling going through.
Yeah.
Even though it has been, I mean, every single night of music has been extraordinary, mm-hmm. just absolutely extraordinary. And so, you know, again, operating on a shoestring and everything, but the musicians want to come back, mm-hmm. and they love it. And, you know, the people that do come here absolutely love it. The people, the audience, even if it's only 20 people or less, the audience just loves it. I mean, we get so many people rave reviews at the end of the night. And so then it's just like, okay, bring 10 of your best friends.
That's
next
right.
time.
Everything starts with an idea. You know, my motto is less talk, more do. And you have an idea and you say, I want to do a series. And I want to have it here, and I want people to come, and I want people to enjoy themselves, and we want, you know, a certain type of musician, and yada, yada, yada. You have two choices. One, you either do it, or you talk yourself out of doing it by sitting in a couch chair and saying, well, this will be the problem, and that'll be the problem. Well, Crazy Squirrel was conceived as an idea, and we just went ahead and did it. Instead of trying to, you know, second guess yourself, you just do it. And I guess this final statement, it's like, be careful what you decide to do, because it's hard work. And unless you're willing to see it through, don't start it.
And I'm very grateful that everybody involved with this year's Crazy Squirrel concert saw it through. And I do think people will be talking about it for a long, long time to come.
Nice.
You know.
Love, we remain. Whoa.